Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you my Funko Pop collection. I have a pretty small collection and all it contains of like 15-ish figures, 17. Yeah, so let's get started. Okay, so I have my Spider-Man Far From Home, Spider-Man, Funko Pop. This is when the movie released, so this was a big kind of like thing. So this was my second Funko Pop I ever got. Yeah, so this is a really cool pop. It's not one of my favorites, it's okay, I guess, in my opinion. So, then, this is my K2 Oso. Well, this is technically my first Funko Pop. My dad bought it for himself and then just gave it to me. So, technically, this is my first Funko Pop. It's not one of my favorites. The box is damaged. It's just kind of a generic figure. It's from Rogue One. Yeah, that's a Star Wars thing. Yep, then I have my Mysterio from the Spider-Man Far From Home as well. This was my first pop I ever got. It's really cool. I really like the design on it. It's really nice, yeah. So. Then, onto my Otter Pop. This is my Sir Isaac Lime Otter Pop. It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's just a fun little pop to have. It was $5 at GameStop, so why not? So this is my gold Demogorgon. We went, like, hunting for this. It took, like, 40 minutes to drive to the Barnes & Noble to get this. Because we originally saw it at the Barnes & Noble near our house. But somebody like grabbed it, like, well, it was on like a pre-order area, like somebody like ordered it off of like online on their like shop or something. Yeah, so they had another one in like a Barnes and Noble that's like an hour away from our house. Yeah, so this one's pretty, it has a pretty funny experience, and it's limited edition. Yeah, so it's a really cool pop. And then I have my Stranger Things Season 3 Dustin Funko Pop. It's really cool. It's when he came back wearing his Camp Nowhere uniform. That what you got? Clothes. Yeah, so Stranger Things is a really cool mystery series. It is not for kids, just so you know. It has bad language and a lot of gore, but I really enjoy it, so this is a cool pop to me. Then I have my Iron Spider Funko Pop. Yeah, this one is from Barnes & Noble. It was one of the Marvel Studios 10th anniversary ones, so it's gold. Yeah, I really like this pop. It's one of my favorites. Yeah, so then I am a huge fan of Ready Player One, the movie and the book. The book is better, in my opinion. So I have the whole high five here. I have the Artemis Funko Pop. I really enjoyed it. She was a really cool character in the series. Yeah, so, well, no, movie, book, not a series. Yeah, so I really think she's cool. And then I have H, Parzival's best friend, if you don't know, in the series. Movie, book. Yeah, he's just a cool, like, kind of, like, side character. Yeah, a lot of these are, like, side characters besides Parzival, the one that I'm about to show. So I have Dieto. So this is the Dieto. I really like the sculpt they did for him. Like, I like how he's like a bigger figure. He's one of my favorites. I really like that like sword that he's holding, and I'm glad it's not like bent, because we got this at a comic book store, so I'm glad like it didn't like get like the sword didn't like bend from like the heat. Yeah, so, then I have my Shul Pop. It's called Shoto in the book. He's called Shoto in the book, but in the movie, he's called Sho. So, these were all for the movie So, yeah, so he's called Cho, that's why. Yeah, he's a really cool pop. I really like him. I love how it's, like, bigger with, like, his hair there. You can't see it because of lighting, and yeah, I have to put this humongous lamp next to me. Then I have my top four favorite pops. I have my, and there is a pop in this box. I have my Clear Perswald Hot Topic exclusive Funko Pop. I don't go to Hot Topic, I go to Secondhand Charles. It's a secondhand store here. It has a humongous collection of pops, at least my store has a bunch of pops. Then I have my He-Man pop. I just got this pop yesterday, and it's really cool. I am a fan of He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, so this was a really cool pop when we found it. Sadly, I can't find the Skeletor. So, yeah, this is a really nice pop. Then, I have my Psycho Shiner pop. It's the... I actually saw this on the Funko Shop, hence why it's the Funko Shop exclusive pop. But you can't buy pops off of there. So we bought this from eBay. It's in great condition. And it's teal because that's why it's the Funko Shop exclusive. I know it's it's purple on it, but it's teal for me because it's the limited edition Funko Pop exclusive. Sorry there. Then I have my Gelatinous Cube. This was one of my favorite pops that is in my collection. It's the 2020 Spring Convention Limited Exclusive. It's really nice. I love D&D. It's a really fun game to play. Yeah, so I really like the Gelatinous Cube. It's really fun. We actually had a Gelatinous Cube in our campaign. Yeah, so then I have my other things. They're either unboxed pops or Pez's or Pocket Pops. So I have my Thor Funko Pop. This is out of box because the box is terrible, so I'd rather just place it out of box. Yeah, so this is a really nice pop. Again, I got this one from my dad. He's a teacher. One of his students gave it to him for, like, his birthday, I'm pretty sure, or something like that. Because knew he liked Marvel. So, yeah, so my dad gave this one to me when I started recollecting. Then I have my BAM exclusive glow-in-the-dark Cthulhu Pop Pez. I ate all the Pez, by the way. Yeah, this is really cool. This is just a cool find. We also found this at Secondhand Charles. I get most of my pops probably at GameStop, maybe? Probably eBay, because I like a lot of old pops, like the Ready Player One pops, so those are kind of like finds on eBay. Well, I couldn't, like, buy them in stores, so we found them on eBay, so that was nice. Yeah, so this is a really cool Pop Pez. And then I have my Captain Crunch Pocket Pop. It's really cool. I like how he's actually holding the cereal in his hand. And this is just, it was $5, so why not? It was a pretty cool pop. And then one of my favorite pops that I own is my Doc Brown, where he's connecting the two. This was a Loot Crate exclusive. Again, the box is terrible, so I didn't decide to place it in box. Just trust me, this is a Loot Crate exclusive. I don't want to get up and find the box. So, just trust me, this is a Loot Crate exclusive. Yeah, it's when at the very end of the first movie, where it's the 1955 Doc Brown. Oh, and this is from Back to the Future, by the way, if you didn't know. Where he's connecting the two, where he's trying to get Marty back into 1985. Yeah, I just really thought that was a cool moment. So to have that moment as a pop is really nice. He even has the scar. Like, this thing is so awesome. He even has, like, the box in the back. Yeah, so this is a really cool pop. So that was all of my Funko Pops. I have some Funkoverse games. That's the Funko-owned game downstairs. I don't bother to bring them up. I have the Kool-Aid Man, Rick and Morty, and the Batman one. The 4-pack Batman, the Kool-Aid Man, and then the Rick and Morty one. My dad's a big fan of Rick and Morty and all those other brands. So that was kind of my pop collection. Thanks for sticking around. I hope you enjoyed. I'm sure I did. So, this is... Bye.